Hey you guys, so today we are making baked apples. And I decided that I wanted to see which type of apple bakes better. I have a Granny Smith organic apple here, and I have a Honeycrisp organic apple here. I tried to get them close in size, but the Honeycrisp is a little bit bigger. But anyways, what I want to do is prepare my healthy baked apple recipe for both of these apples and see which one turns out better. Obviously, the Honeycrisp is probably going to be a little bit more sweet, but there could be variation in the texture and then just the overall experience of the apples. So let's get to work. I actually have these bowls because I can bake in them. So I'm going to prepare each apple and then just put these babies right in the oven. So for this recipe, we're going to make a sauce in my Nutribullet because I love my Nutribullet. We have 1 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1 tablespoon of olive oil, and then 3 medjool dates. And I love dates. When I sweeten anything, I always use dates. I try to stay away from refined sugar. One thing you should know about dates, depending on where you buy them or how you buy them, you want to make sure they're pitted. So if they're not, you want to remove the pits first. So just take the pit out if you don't know what I'm talking about. We have our 3-ingredient applesauce. We're just going to put it in the Nutribullet. Very simple. The 3 dates. Okay, that's what we have here. Okay, so add like 1/4 cup of water so that this will blend into kind of like a thick kind of syrup. Here's the homemade syrup that we will be pouring on our apples. So this part, we're just going to cut the apple into small pieces. I'm leaving the skin on. I've seen some baked apple recipes with the skin removed, but the skin has a lot of nutritional value, so why cut it off? That's kind of what I think. Now for the Honeycrisp. So we have our apples. We have the green and the Honeycrisp. Now I'm just going to drizzle the date syrup, or kind of like a paste, over the apples. Okay, and make sure that they're coated completely. Ooh, that's gonna be good, y'all. Okay, so I'm gonna kind of mix these up a little bit because I want the apples to be completely covered in the paste. Okay, and then we're gonna cover them with tin foil. Our apples are ready to go in the oven. I'm gonna put them on 350 for 20 minutes and we'll see how this goes. I have a big toaster oven so I can fit a lot of stuff in here. I love it. Okay, we'll be back with the results in 20 minutes. Okay, so it's been 20 minutes and I'm super excited because the apples are ready. Hey Freddy, the apples are ready. Are you ready? So over here we have the green apple. They smell so amazing. And here is a Honeycrisp apple. And it's way too crispy. Let me see how this goes. Mm-hmm. It was really good. It's a little bit tart. I'm gonna do this one. So what I can tell you is that the green apple is cooked in the 20 minutes, but the Honeycrisp apple is still kind of crisp. So maybe that's why they call it a Honeycrisp. You never know. I like this flavor, but it needs to go back in the oven, so we'll be back in like 10 more minutes. While I'm waiting for the Honeycrisp to finish cooking, I'm assuming it's gonna take like another 10 minutes because they were pretty not cooked when I took them out after 20. I just went and grabbed some fresh pecans because I'm like, these could really go for some pecans. But anyways, I started kind of tasting this green apple and it's really, really, really good. It's just kind of tart, but it's the right texture after 20 minutes. The flavor is really, really good. I mean, I know this probably doesn't look like what you would expect an apple recipe to look like, but look, it's about health and wealth, and health is wealth, and this actually really tastes good. It tastes like apple crisp without the crisp. These are really good. You guys should try this, like, really good. And the pecan in there is really good. You have to try these. They're so simple and they're so delicious. And don't forget, medjool dates have so many nutrients and antioxidants, and you gotta look them up, find out what their nutritional value is, but it's a great substitute for sugar. And I'm sorry, I'm talking with my mouth full, so I'm gonna stop. So it's been 10 minutes and I pretty much have eaten the entire green apple. This was so good. I mean, it looks sloppy, but what a magnificent treat. This is a Honeycrisp apple. And we're just gonna mix it up a little bit and see how this goes. It's nice and hot. And you know what? You guys should make these apples just to smell up your kitchen, because it smells so delicious and delightful. Besides, it tastes so good too. So I'm gonna dig in and see. I can already tell this is a little bit better texture. I really like this one, but as you can tell, it's still a little bit too crisp. Well, this is the green apple and this is the Honeycrisp, and clearly the green apple wins. The green apple wins by far. Texture, flavor, the tartness, it really makes for a wonderful baked apple. Cook for 20 minutes on 350. I know this looks like a mess, a hot mess actually, but this is delicious and you don't have to feel guilty. It literally tastes like apple crisp without the crispy, crumbly, floury, you know, extras. It's just a simple baked apple and you can pop it in the oven when you're doing whatever else around the house, but you should definitely try this. It's super easy. And maybe experiment with different apples, but the green apple, I'm feeling it. So this Honeycrisp, not so much. It's still too crisp after 30 minutes of baking, but if you like baked crisp apples, then this might be your jam. That's all, folks.